referee's going to make sure. And if he does, it's on his shoulders. He's in charge.
Somebody needs to hit you with a clue stick.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been an eventful night here on Monday Night Raw. The night started with Kane in the ring spreading his hate before John Cena turned this thing into a brawl that went out into the parking lot.
You're right. All the way out onto the loading dock, these two superstars fought. And the big red monster was teetering right about to go over the edge when he slammed. Slammed John into those steel poles. But look at that. There's a crowbar right there. Oh, right into the left knee of Kane.
Yeah, but Kane still had offense left. Watch this. And then as Cena's days, when he finally comes to, Kane had disappeared. No one knew where he went.
Well, we do know that that big red monster is still lurking somewhere in the shadows.
That's what I call marine biology.
John, listen, I just gotta say thanks. I gotta say thanks again. I mean, you gave up a shot at your championship, so I get a chance to win mine.
And we already
listen,
went through that.
I know, I'm the U.S. champ now. And last week, Kane was trying to drag me to hell, and you saved me, bro. You saved me. I mean, I gotta thank you for that. And I saw you chase off Kane tonight, and I'll be honest, I'm still a little weirded out. I don't know if it's about Kane or Eve or my title match against
Swagger. Hey, whoa, wait. You left out the most important thing.
What?
This week, at Zack Ryder, passed the Miz on Twitter, making you, at Zack Ryder, one of the top five most followed WWE superstars.
That's true, yeah.
Listen, man, we went over this. I told you it was gonna get a little hectic. I'll help you out where I can, but you gotta keep it together, all right?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, you'll be brother. Fine.
I'm an A-lister.
Nikki, I'm the A-lister.
No, I'm the A-lister.
Out of us both, come on. I'm kind of like the Stacey Keebler.
Oh, the nobody?
Ladies.
Hey.
Why did you guys make me come all the way out here from Mexico?
Well, we personally wanted to give you a message to give to Alberto.
Yes. Goes, haven't you ladies ever heard of, oh, I don't know, a cell phone? I think it probably would have made it a little easier, don't you think?
Anyways, what we want you to tell Alberto
Del Rio can wait. You, Ricardo, are going to go out to that ring and you're going to call out our truth.
Sounds local.
No, it's not. See, every other so-called superstar is so scared of our truth that they won't go with me on this. That's why you're going to do it. You are going to march out to that ring and you're going to say the most offensive thing that you could possibly think of. You're going to draw out our truth and I'll take care of the rest.
Come on, it's not going to happen.
No, it's not?
No.
Yes, it is. Because if it doesn't happen, I'm going to make you join Alberto Del Rio on the injured list right now.
So, ladies, how about you girls join me to the ring?
Absolutely not.
Good.
Go to that ring right now. On delay.
You know, that's why in my mind The Miz is a future Hall of Famer, because he's bilingual.
Well, speaking of the Hall of Fame, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to announce the second inductee. Well, first of all, before we do that.
Yeah, you're getting carried away.
Well, I'm excited about this.
Earlier tonight, we announced the first inductee into the 2012 WWE Hall of Fame, none other than Edge.
I'm excited about Edge, but let's now announce the second inductee into the WWE Hall of Fame Class of 2012.
One symbol of excellence. Two decades of prominence. Three indelible words.
Diamonds are forever!
Four unforgettable superstars.
And so are the four horsemen, yeah!
J.J. Dillon, Ric Flair, Anderson, Blanchard, Barry Windham, the studs in professional wrestling.
They all were very tight. They did hang around each other. They were real friends. They were living that lifestyle. They were wrestling and stealing the show.
The Four Horsemen is not just an idea. It's a theme. It's a state of being. It's a state of mind.
Arn Anderson was the enforcer of the group. By far, the toughest member of the Four Horsemen.
I don't want to say I told you so. I don't want to blow our own horn, but toot, toot.
Arn never quite got credit for the amazing talent that he was in this industry.
And for all you people out there that have ever bought a ticket to see Arn Anderson wrestle, I gave you everything I had.
If I was trying to describe Ric Flair to somebody who didn't know him, I'd say, where have you been for the last 30 years under a rock?
It is so hard to be humble when you're looking like Ric Flair. Tully Blanchard is on top of the whole heap one more time.
Tully Blanchard was the first cool bad guy that I ever saw.
We can get down and be dirty with the dirtiest of them all, but we can also be as clean as they come.
I'm Barry Windham, the most natural gifted athlete ever to walk into our business.
Barry is so good that he can blend in with anybody. He was the absolute best in the world.
The Four Horsemen are not four individuals. We're a unit.
There is a camaraderie that is unparalleled anywhere else.
The class of the world are Horsemen fans. They believe in the symbol of success. Diamonds are forever, and so are the Horsemen.
And congratulations to the Four Horsemen, who will now join Edge, inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame Class of 2012 on WrestleMania weekend, the night before WrestleMania. Now there's Ricardo Rodriguez, who has been forced out here to quote Miz to draw out our truth.
Miz, I really hope you're watching this. Our truth, you need to come out here for this. Eres una persona muy mala. You're really bad, man. And your mother, tu mamá está bien fea. She's really ugly. She has a mustache.
What?
You smell like a wet donkey, and your breath stinks really bad, like a run burrito, and
the truth has set me free.
I think our truth has heard enough. A rotten burrito. What else did he say about it? I mean, yeah, but Archer, you saw he just took the breath test. Yeah, but I mean, you didn't smell it. I've been around the guy. He's got bad breath.
You should talk. Here's a stun of moose.
Oh, Lucy, I'm home. Hola, Ricardo. I don't know why you want to pick a fight with me. You got it all wrong. I'm not a bad man. You see, I'm a good R-Truth. In fact, little Jimmy, yeah, little Jimmy told me that I should let bygones be bygones and let you go. Little Jimmy! Little Jimmy,
Should I let Ricardo go?
No!
Uh-oh! Little Jimmy don't think much of you, Ricardo. Little Jimmy want me to turn Ricardo into a human piñata.
Miss, where are you, please, miss?
Get a hold of yourself, man. You bugging out like a little cockroach. Little cockroach. Will you sing me and little Jimmy a song? I said, will you sing me and Jimmy a song? You know that song, La Cucaracha. Sing a song.
La Cucaracha.
No, no, no. Little Jimmy wants you to do it from that.